So even though the State of the Union is happening here in the Capitol, all across the country, we have our candidates who are busy running for office. One in particular is our good friend Rick Santorum, who I guess if you were to like count off the clock of conservatives, he sort of tops the cakes.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
So Santorum may not achieve anything resembling, like there's no way that Rick Santorum is going to actually win the presidential debate whatsoever, not even remotely. Right? Like, it's not happening. He's not going to win the primary. He won't win a state. But he's always colorful for saying the craziest thing, especially when it comes to the LGBTQ folks in this country.
When people have a voice, they take advantage of it.
Yes, you put a microphone in Rick Santorum's face, and I guarantee you he's going to take advantage of it in America. And this is an example of this. So this is what he says. I want to read this exactly. He says, look, I'm very proud of a conservative record I've put together. There's no one who has fought more for morals and cultural issues. I'm not a libertarian. There are people, and he goes on and on and on and on, but it's my favorite. For me, when you say the states have the right to define marriage, it's like saying, well, the states have the right to redefine the chemical equation of water. It can be H3O instead of H2O. Well, the states can't do that. Why? Because nature dictates what water is. Nature dictates what marriage is. And the states don't have the right to violate what nature dictates.
So
from yours truly,
he's
Rick
pretty
Santorum.
Much calling anyone that isn't heterosexual and
you
alien.
Are against nature.
You're not human.
You're extraterrestrial.
So what are you?
You don't belong on Earth.
You're not an earthly being.
Sorry. Maybe next year, maybe in your reincarnation, you might be a humanly being, but right now you live in another planet, according to Rick Santorum. Because you cannot create H3O. Who
says
these things?
I don't know. Honestly, it's really frustrating to me that someone can even have the voice to say something like that.
Here's the thing. I'm not frustrated by ignorance or stupidity, because you shouldn't be.
Yeah.
And I think Rick Santorum is the definition of both ignorance and stupidity. I mean,
it's just so rude. Like, you're just...
Well, he doesn't. Here's the thing. He doesn't care about being rude. That's what you got to... Like, with Rick Santorum, you've got to start believing, number one, and this guy is perfectly rude. He hates people,
yeah.
Right? He hates black people. He hates Latinos. Yeah. He wants to get rid of all them. He definitely probably hates Muslims. He definitely hates gay people. And if you're a woman had an abortion, he hates you too.
Yeah.
But he does love Jesus. In that order. You see how hypocritical that is, America? Like, he loves Jesus, and Jesus is supposed to be quote-unquote love, but he hates everything else.
What I really love is the long build-up to the final statement of, like, anyone that is in a gay community is not human. Like, he likes to talk about Earth, he likes to talk about water, everything else.
But the crazy part is, like, he talks about nature, right? And, like, I don't understand. So he's pro, which makes this even crazier, right? Like, so he's pro nature and pro-natural law, but he's okay with fracking.
Yeah.
He's okay with drilling in Anwar.
Yeah.
Oh, but if you're gay, you are against nature. I'm always for nature all the time, 100% of the time. Insane, America. Absolutely, positively insane.